everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Mega Bloks Collector Series set. This is a Call of Duty set here. It's called Drone Attack, number 06813, comes with 95 pieces. Now this cost $10 at Toys R Us where I got it, and I want to let you know right from the start that I am not a Call of Duty player. I'm not particularly a Call of Duty fan. So I'm going to be reviewing this as a toy, and I'm not going to have all the buzzwords and all the super specific specs and names and everything for every single component. So if that bugs you, don't watch this video. I'm just going to be looking at this as a toy, as a fan of construction sets. Now, let me start with the vehicle, because it's the bigger thing, but it's actually less of a big deal than the figure is. This is from Black Ops 2, and it is an either fully autonomous or player controllable drone vehicle called the AGR or the ASR, depending upon whether you're multiplayer or single player. This is a deployable weapons platform, and it has machine guns on one side, so just regular projectile weapons, and missiles on the other. This is supposed to have four barrels on it in-game. I think they did an okay job of approximating the look of it. It looks good. It looks really good. And I very much appreciate the fact that it actually has a turret top, so this turns around. And these can also change in their attitude up and down. And yeah, it's pretty well captured. In scale, you can move the treads back and forth. They're kind of soft, the treads are, so they don't get too stuck. A lot of times when toy companies make treaded vehicles, they make the treads just so tough so that they don't rip that it's hard to move them. But these aren't too bad, not too bad. They do have a little spot where they want to get stuck, but it's all right. There is one thing that I definitely do not like about this design or this assembly. The tips of these things trying to be missiles over here, the way they're attached, they just pop right off. Just so easy. Look at that. Just breaks right off. That's terrible. Really terrible. And it's just because the parts did not get molded quite properly. I think it might be two different types of plastic, and they shrunk different amounts coming out of the molds, and now they just don't stick, so they just fall right off. To fix that reliably, you need to use these double-sided pin pieces. Now they gave me one extra one with this set, so I can actually demonstrate in one place without adding extra parts, but put that on there. That's not coming off. That's perfect. And it's also actually just a little bit longer the way that it's, you can see it sticks out a little bit more. So if you have extras of those in your collection, use them here. You will need them, because they otherwise, unless it was just this batch or something, this batch of parts that don't fit together so well. Let me not stay on that for too long, because I want to get to the figure. But my favorite thing about this set is the new design for the camo. It has so many different textures in it, so they got a lot of different colors. They've got kind of a marbling effect going on in there, you can see in some of the pieces, and there are also flecks, so small little bits of color, and a lot of different colors, so it really makes it look just several cuts above the norm for level of detail and randomness in texture on just regular construction plastic parts. So I really like this. Now, the figure. This is the first Collector Series Call of Duty Mega Bloks set that I have reviewed, and it's the first time that I've seen one of these new figures. They are positively incredible. They set the bar for level of detail and configurability. These are incredible. I'm going to do an entire video just going over what these are all about, this whole new building design for these figures. It's a big deal. So like I said, I will do a separate video just on that, and also compare it to a couple of other types of figures in minifig size. But as you can see, we've got a very, very dynamic pose going on here. This is a pose that you normally would not be able to get out of something so small. But here's the thing, it's fully, fully poseable. I made it put in, you know, go into that pose. This is unbelievable. All these parts are put together separately. But look at this, you've got a huge range of motion in the shoulders. They're not ball joints, they actually go in there. They're socketed pretty well in. And it's two axes here, so you can rotate up and down. You can go across, look at how far across you can go. The elbows also have two axes, so you can adjust this axis. You can also rotate the whole thing like this. So it gives you two axes of rotation that really allow you to fine-tune the exact pose you want to get. The hands just have rotation at the wrist. Pretty good looking hands. They actually have details of the fingers or gloves on there. You've got, again, with the new design, the new style of camo with flex in there. This is just incredible. Now, down for the hips, so we've got waist. We've got waist articulation. The hips can actually move back and forth ever so slightly inside of there, but then ball joints for the thighs, and then just a straight single axis knee joint. Tons of range of motion. You can actually bring it up above a 90 degree there. And then the attachment of things onto here. So I'll show you the gun again in a second, but this vest is attached separately. The belt is a separate piece. So for other versions of the soldier, you'll be able to get different colors of belts. And you can actually arrange it in different ways. You've got a little magazine right here, and you've got a grenade. Those are attached. You can remove those. Here's the magazine. It has a little slot on one side, and you can see there's a square or rectangular small peg, which is a new standard that they've used. Here's the grenade. Take that off, and you can see the two kind of hard points that they put onto the vest. And then there's one on the side of the belt over here. So if I wanted to attach this here, I could just, whoops, it's really small stuff, but there you go. You can attach that there. You've got another point on the back of the belt. So if I wanted to put the magazine back there instead, I could. There's still a hole in the back of the figure of the torso. So I can put in a backpack instead of the vest. Take those off. Got the knife that's on a strap on his thigh in this case, and this is also attached using the new standard with the rectangular peg. So you've got all these things that you can change and alter and customize. You know, you can put different things in different places, and you'll see with other releases, other figures from this series that you'll be able to mix and match things. Here's the weapon. It's based on an assault rifle base, kind of the AR-15 center section, and you have actually interchangeable barrels. So this barrel can actually be taken off, and that uses a taller rectangular peg style. So there will be different barrels that can be attached to the thing. The stock can also be removed. You can just use it like that. You know, no stock, pistol grip, straight on. There are different types of stocks that they will give you that you'll be able to use. And then for the ammo here, so this is unusual for ammo. This is a box magazine with a belt feed. So it actually has linked ammo there, which is not entirely common for this type of weapon. But if you don't like that, if you don't want to have the big heavy box magazine, they use what's called a dovetail joint, which is something that actually slides. Yeah, I think you can actually see it right in there. It's a particular shape that just creates it has a tongue and groove basically that link together. That's not coming out on its own. That is very nice. And then, so here's your standard kind of a short magazine that he had mounted onto him previously. That just goes right on there, kind of locks in place with friction. So there's, you know, more of a standard appearance that you would expect. They also have one of those dovetail joints up here on the top rail, so you'll be able to add different optics and sighting systems onto this exact same core of the weapon. So it's highly configurable, and the more different sets that you get, the more different weapon configurations you'll be able to put together. And however you want to play, or however you want to simulate a situation, if you want them to be able to, you know, have something light and keep it close, or even go one-handed, you know, being a real tough guy, you can pull off that look. And you've got so many different things you can do with the hands that you can really get the angle that you want. Or if you want to bring it in tight, like you saw earlier when I started this off, I had it in really close. You can see how close you can get this to the face of the character, to the body, and the hand will also hold on up here towards the front. Like so, you can actually hold on there, so you actually get a good grip. And just so many different things that you can do with these. It's pretty incredible. But I will do an entire separate video, like I said, even after going through all this, I'll do a separate video to show you even more detail about how these guys are built and how they compare in size and abilities to other figures. So there you go. That's the so-called drone attack AGR or ASR set number 06813 from Mega Bloks Collector Series in Call of Duty. This is from, again, the Black Ops 2 era. Thank you very much for watching. I've got more reviews to come for sure, so be sure to stay tuned to JANGBRiCKS.com. Make sure you don't miss anything. You can also oftentimes see things before they're released to YouTube, and also see updates that won't ever get videos because they don't really need them. So I'll be talking to you again soon.